We have a lot of things to discuss in this video, so make sure you stick around. What we're basically having here is the air filter after 27,000 kilometers, the oil and the filters after 10,000 kilometers. We have the new chain kit, which it's composed by the chain and the two sprockets, this one and this one. And last but not least, we have here the rear bearing kit. Now let's speak in detail about each single one. For the chain kit, I've chosen the DID Professional Motorcycle Chain 520 ZVM-X. This is the gold and gold edition. You'll see it, it looks very nice. Yes, indeed. Let's check inside. As you can see, it looks very nice. It comes in a package with the O-rings and with a connection link. It's an O-ring chain. The chain is already greased. It's made in Japan, as you can see written on the links. 520 ZVMX. You can see how the chain is already lubed, and you can check out the amount of grease between the O-rings. I've already reached 32,000 kilometers with the original chain, so I'm planning to change it very soon. And this one seems to me like a very good option. Let's check out also the sprockets. For the sprockets, I've chose the JT Sprockets. The front sprocket has 17 teeth. It's SCM42020 CR Mo Chromoly Steel. Leading Power Transfer Engineering. JTSprockets.com. The rear sprocket has 39 teeth. It's a heat induction hardened high carbon steel, they say. And this is how the sprockets are looking. This is the front sprocket. It looks very good, very quality made. It has also a code over here, GTF137317RB. And this is the rear sprocket, also very quality made, looks very tough. Nice fabric. And it also has a code over here, GTR131639. The next parts are representing the rear bearing kit. The rear bearing kit is composed out of two similar bearings. One bearing separately, 225015, two simerings and one O-ring. I will leave you in the video description all the codes for all these parts, so you can check it for yourself. Let's speak in detail about each one of them. These are the bearings. They look very good. They have some lube inside. They are very nice. We have also something written here, Japan, NSK, also case 37, EC12, and the 6204DU. These are the codes which are written on these bearings.
And this is the simering. It's a 3047 7.5, and it has also a lube already placed here, as you can see on the inside over here. I hope you can visualize. This is the second simmering, a 3057. Another code over here, it's 121102 MRN. This is the classic one. This is a separate bearing which comes in this rear bearing kit. This is a 22B5015 NSE Japan. It also has some lube on it. It says Naki. Very nice. And the final piece of the puzzle is this O-ring from the rear bearing kit. I've bought this kit as a prevention measure. We'll see if it's necessary to change it in the near future. Now let's move forward and inspect a little bit this air filter and see how it looks after 27,000 kilometers. We have had the various riding conditions. I would say around 20% off-road. We had rain, mud, and dust also. And this is how the filter looks after 27,000 kilometers on the Honda NC750X. And this is how the back of the filter is looking. Here it looks a little bit clean. So I will recommend that you change it after 22,000 kilometers. In the book it says 24,000, but you can make it earlier, why not, depending on your riding conditions. And here we have the oil filters. We have here the normal oil filter and we have here the DCT filter, which is a little bit smaller. This is the DCT filter after 10,000 kilometers. This is how it looks. And here we have a code for it, 9V06. And this is the oil filter after 10,000 kilometers. There was also a ring around here on the filters. And the best part will be to see exactly how the oil looks after 10,000 kilometers on the bike. And we prepare something. Now it's time to put the oil in a jar and look closely to the color. And basically that's the color of the oil. More darker than lighter, so I let you judge it. We'll try to put it also in front of the natural light to see it better. So this is its natural color after 10,000 kilometers on the natural light. You can see it for yourself. Thank you very much for watching. I really hope that this video was helpful for you. Until next time, bye bye.